สวัสดีค่ะก็พอดีไม่ได้เตรียมภาษาไทยมาเดี๋ยวอาจารย์จะเรียนค่ะ Good morning, my name is Prani Rothian. I'm working at the Fifth Regional Livestock Office as a zoonosis veterinary officer. Thank you so much for the triple D on holding this conference. And it's a great pleasure and privilege for us to work together to make ready a history under one health concept. We would like to share an experience investigation and a pattern of rabies outbreaks control after imported rabies puppy into Chiang Mai by November 2011. As many of you know that rabies is a furious zoonotic disease. Almost mammal can be infected and clinical side animal is all finally die. Dog is the main cause of the rabies in human. In Chiang Mai, there is no human rabies report more than 5 years. The latest two human rabies cases were found in 2006. Bangkok has the Bangkok had the highest incidence of animal rabies in the top 5 of Thailand. It's the new version of the... Is it new old? It's very... Okay. The upper northern part, the latest animal rabies case was found in 2009 at Samsai District in Chiang Mai. Sorry for the PowerPoint, not so good. Since 2009, then rabies-free area project has been established in Chiang Mai and continues to evaluate up to now. However, a rabies outbreak case was informed by the Upper Northern Veterinary and Research Development Center. Chiang Mai One Health Team Network immediately investigated in order to verify the outbreak and seek the source of infection. The description was conducted to review the rabies situation in Chiang Mai at least the past 5 years, interview the pet holder by the standardized questionnaire rabies form constructed by the Department of Livestock Development to search for rabies contact both in human and animal. The relevant organization meeting was held for set up rabies control implementation pattern and a passive and active surveillance both in human and animal were manipulated. And all animal were quarantined and restrict movement. This infection was performed at the premise. Dog and cats were all immunized and exposure animal and human were close to health practice follow the clinical guidelines. And government announced the temporary rabies outbreak area with the document by the provincial authority. Moreover, we also test for the protective antibody in the post-exposure and vaccination in human and animal population. From the investigation, this rabies contact puppy was brought from Thon Nui District in Bangkok, where were affected by flooding in 2011 and carried to Chiang Mai province by a car on 30 September. The owner place was indicated at the, by a point on this map. After 3 weeks, the puppy shows the of depression, crying, anorexia, aggressive and fight cast in the same case was bitten. Later on, the owner was also bitten by this aggressive puppy. Consequence, the puppy was sent to the Care for Dog Foundation, which was shown on the B point, which is not so far from the city. Care for Dog Shelter is located in Hang Dong District, about 13 kilometers from the first place. The puppy was kept in a cage, but opened the opportunity to contact other 12 dogs in the shelter. The next day, puppy showed more signs of a non-appetite, aggressive, barking, and bloody diarrhea, and did the other dog, five dogs include a volunteer? Well, the puppy then sent to a private animal hospital, which is located in Chiang Mai City, about 5 kilometers from the owner place. And either parvovirus and or December infection was suspected, but it revealed negative to both by test kit. This crazy dog is dead on 29 October, say about 1 month after import from Bangkok. For safety of the clinician and animal doctor, sent the dead puppy to the laboratory at Lampang Veterinary Research and Development Center. The result showed positive to rabies by fluorescent antibody technique. We found many human and animal exposed to this rabies puppy in all three pests concerned. 7 out of 22 contact person was bitten by this rabbit puppy, and the rest of 15 persons were contact with a puppy saliva. Highest number is in care for dog children. Fortunately, almost all of them were foreigner volunteer who had already got the pre-exposure immunization. However, all of them were again vaccinated, follow the post-exposure rabies criteria. Dog and cat population in risk area were further surveyed for vaccination planning, and nearly 100,000 dogs and cat population were lived in these two districts. From little perspective, the work of both municipality, almost the dog and cat in this both district were vaccinated about over 80% according to rabies free area establishment project in Chiang Mai since 2000 up to now. For epidemiological descriptive analysis and outbreak control planning, we hold a meeting among relevant organizations, including livestock, public health, local administration, university, non-government organization, and we have to integrate the human and material resource for effective implementation. The implementation we define for the better appropriate management of a rabies control into three levels of high risk, moderate risk, and low risk area, with a zoning by radius of 1, 3, and 5 km from each premise, respectively. A public awareness and animal quarantine was implemented to all risk areas, and rabies vaccination was repeated to all dogs and cats in the high risk area. In the moderate risk area, we did booster for all and the animal with a had only single vaccinated, and all puppy dogs which never vaccinated. For the low risk area, only young dogs and cats with not more than 3 months were all vaccinated. However, active surveillance for sending off all dead mammals for rabies diagnosis had been done throughout the province. In the high-risk area, 5 cats and 189 dogs, which were approached bitten by the rabid puppy dog, were vaccinated and quarantined for clinical size observation every 6 months. Total of 8,600 dogs from 10,000 dogs, about 86% was immunized. And the bitten dogs and cats were vaccinated 4 times on 4 days intervals. All samples of a complete immunized human and adult dogs show higher rabies protective antibody titer than young dogs, which have too low protective level after single vaccination. So conclusion that we recommend for effective control of rabies include integrated management of rabies control program among UN's organizations, stringent movement of dog population, and rabies preparation, laboratory confirmation in suspected rabies animal, expanding immunization covering in all animal population. Lastly, active fighting among exposed human and animal to rabies should be strengthened and follow a prevention program in clinical practice guideline. Thank you.